नमः शिवाय स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 17, दैट इज फॉरेस्ट आवर लाइफ लाइन एंड वी आर लर्निंग अबाउट इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फॉरेस्ट. पहले आस्ट, देयर आर सो मेनी ट्रीज हियर, ऑल्सो देयर आर मेनी फॉरेस्ट लाइक दिस. व्हाट डिफरेंस विल इट मेक इफ वी कट सम ट्रीज फॉर अ फैक्ट्री? प्रोफेसर अहमद सेड, यू हैव रेड अबाउट ऑटोट्रॉप्स, हेटरोट्रॉप्स and saprotrophs, right students? You have learned how green plants produce food by the process of photosynthesis. That's why they are called autotrophs. And we also have learned that heterotrophs and saprotrophs cannot prepare their own food. Heterotrophs get their food from the autotrophs, and the saprotrophs grows on the dead and decaying matter. Clear? So all animals, whether herbivore or carnivores, depend ultimately on plants for food. Organisms which feed on plants often get eaten by other organisms, and so on. Let's take one example. What is that? Grass is eaten by insects, which in turn is taken by the frog. Then the frog is consumed by snakes. This is said to form a food chain. It's shown with this flow chart. You can see here. You know, many food chains can be found in the forest. All food chains are linked. If any of food chain is disturbed, it affects other food chains. Every part of the forest is dependent on the other parts. If we remove one component, say like trees, all other components would be affected. Let us try to understand this phenomenon clearly with the help of this slide. Okay, you know, the living organisms like plants interact with soil to obtain nutrients, okay, like mineral salts for their growth. The plants interact with water that is present in the soil or in the water bodies to get water for making food by the process of photosynthesis. And plants also interact with air to obtain carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. Yeah, we all know about that. Now all those components, green plants prepare their food. That's why they are called producers. We all know that. Now in the next step, plants and animals also interact with one another through their food chains, in which one organism eats another organism's. Now, grass is a kind of plant. In a forest, grass or any green plant is eaten by insects. Here, you know, I have shown through these food chains. Now, those insects are also eaten by frogs or any other omnivore. It could be the mouse, rat, anyone. Those omnivores, here we can take this rat or you can take frog, are eaten up by snake. And finally, the snake may be eaten up by an eagle. So, a common food chain occurring in a forest habitat, you can find in that way. And when those carnivores, means this eagle diet, decomposers act on them and convert into humus. That is again provided to the plant nutrient. Can you getting it? This is just one example of the food chain taking place in a forest. In fact, many different food chains can be found in a forest. All the food chains in a forest are interlinked to form a food web. You can see in the third eye photograph. Okay. Here you can see it. Okay. This one. This is one food chain. You can see the plant is been taken by the goat, and then goat is then taken by the jackal, and then by jackal by the lion. Now many simultaneously, many such food chain goes on, and it is called food web. Clear? You know, if any food chain of a food web is disturbed, it affects many other food chains. For example, if you remove all the snakes from a forest, then all the food chains in which snakes take part will be broken or affected. In this way, every part of the forest is dependent on its other parts. Please note that every food chain in the forest starts with plants. Okay, This is because the plants are producers of food. They are autotrophs, right? So the first step in every food chain is the plants. I hope now it is clear to you how the plants or the animals are interdependent on each other. And yes, we must include decomposers also, because they also play a great role by converting those dead and decaying plants material into the humus. Clear? Professor Ahmed asked children to pick up leaves from the forest floor and observe them under a hand lens. They found tiny mushrooms over the decaying leaves. They also saw an army of tiny insects, millipedes, ants and beetle on them. They were wondering how those organisms live there. Professor Ahmed explained that apart from these animals, which are easily seen, there are several organisms and microorganisms that live in the soil. Paheli wondered what mushrooms and other microorganisms eat. Professor Ahmed replied that they feed upon the dead plants and animal tissues and convert them into a dark color substances called humus. In the chapter 9, that is soil, you must have read about the humus, right? That the uppermost horizon is generally dark in color as it is rich in humus and minerals. And also the humus makes the soil fertile and provides nutrient to growing plants, right? So the microorganisms which convert the dead plants and animals to humus are known as decomposers. As we know that these microorganisms play an important role in the forest. Soon Paheli removed some dead leaves and discovered under them a layer of humus on forest floor. The presence of humus ensures that the nutrients of the dead plants and animals are released into the soil. From there, these nutrients are again absorbed by the root of the living plants. What happens if an animal dies in the forest? Sheila asked. Tibu replied, the dead animals become food for vultures, crows, jackals and insects. In this way, the nutrients are cycled. So, it is clear to you that when the animals die in a forest, they are eaten up by some other animals called scavengers, like vultures and crows. The decomposers, organisms like bacteria and fungi decompose the dead plant materials, dead animals and animal waste present in the forest into mineral salts, water and carbon dioxide, which go into soil and air. Since dead animals are eaten up and the materials present in dead plants, dead animals and animal waste are recycled, therefore there is no waste left in the forest. Clear? Today up to this. In my next video, we will discuss more about the forest. Namaste.